Hi everyone, thank you for coming to my talk. My name is Priscilla Seabourn and I'm here to discuss mosquito-borne diseases and their continued threat to public health and wildlife conservation. The impact mosquitoes have had to Hawaii dates back to the 1800s when they first hitched a ride aboard a cargo shipment. Since then, they have been responsible for the transmission of avian malaria and the decline of the native bird populations. They have also been responsible for the transmission of viruses like dengue to humans, with the most recent outbreak occurring in 2015 on the island of Hawaii. To combat this, my research is centered around the surveillance of a medically important mosquito, Aedes albopictus, and its microbiome. The microbiome consists of a community of microorganisms that include bacteria, archaea, fungi, protozoa, and viruses that live on or within a host organism. The microbiome modulates the physiological traits of mosquitoes by interfering with reproduction, stimulating immune responses, and even interacting with the pathogens that it will subsequently transmit to us. These interactions vary, however, and this is because the microbiome varies significantly among mosquito populations. The microbiome has the ability to alter the way mosquitoes vector disease. And these variations are why certain mosquito populations are able to transmit pathogens more effectively and others of the same species are not. This variation is understudied in medically important mosquitoes like Aedes albopictus. So to address this gap, I surveyed Aedes albopictus and its microbiome on the island of Maui for 1 year. And we chose Maui because of the distinct habitats that are located on this island that range from desert-like conditions to tropical forest. Now what we see is that Aedes albopictus is widespread throughout the island of Maui, as indicated by the green dots, indicating that this mosquito can adapt to different habitats located in the state of Hawaii. When we looked at the microbiome, we wanted to assess how different ecological and environmental factors influence the microbiome. So we looked at things like temperature and rainfall. We also looked at a parasite known as Ascogregorina, which is found to be widely prevalent in mosquitoes. We looked at the bacterial endosymbiont Wolbachia, which again is found highly prevalent in our mosquito, as well as majority of insects. So what we found was that these factors do actually influence the microbiome of Aedes albopictus mosquitoes. For example, the bacteria Methylobacterium increased in abundance when we had higher amounts of rainfall. Chrysobacterium actually decreased in bacterial abundance, but it increased when the parasite Ascogregorina was present. Other species of bacteria were not influenced by these different factors, such as Azaia, that it had no change in its bacterial abundance when exposed to these different conditions. Now, what this shows is that the environment does play a role in this giant puzzle of why the mosquito microbiome is so variable. But why do we care? And that's kind of why we're all here, yeah? The microbiome of mosquitoes can allow us to predict which mosquitoes have a higher risk of transmitting certain pathogens, and even allow us to predict future outbreaks. Other applications for the microbiome is utilizing it to create mosquitoes that are incapable of transmitting certain pathogens. This is work that's already been done in Australia with the creation of a mosquito that cannot transmit dengue. It is very clear that understanding the drivers of variation will help us to help us promote these disease prevention strategies. The impact mosquitoes have in Hawaii and globally is still seen, and surveillance needs to incorporate new and innovative techniques to prevent mosquito-borne disease. Thank you.